Edith Stein was born into a conservative German Jewish family in 1891. By her early teens, Edith drifted into atheism. She was a brilliant student, and in her mid-20s was awarded a doctorate in philosophy. Now, somehow she came upon the autobiography of St. Teresa of Avila, and she wrestled with the meaning of Jesus of Nazareth. The Lord found her, and in 1922 she was baptized as a Catholic Christian. For 11 years, Edith taught in Dominican College, studied the philosophy of St. Thomas Aquinas, and translated some of his works into German. But because of the Nazi anti-Semitic laws, in 1933, she was forced out of her teaching role. Now, she was no shrinking violet, and Edith Stein wrote this letter to Pope Pius XI in 1933. Remember the date. It's rather important. She wrote, well, apparently it's locked. But the whole point of the letter was she read, "Dear Holy Father, at this present time, Germany is undergoing violent persecution among the Jewish people of its people. And I'm writing to you because you are the father of Christians. And if anyone should know what should be done and how Germany should be challenged, it should be you. And if you are silent, I hesitate to think what is going to become of Germany in the future." Her letter was much more poetic than that. But even it is not known if even read Edith's letter. "Lord," someone asked Jesus, "are only a few people being saved?" You know, Jesus was not in the habit of giving straight answers to such simplistic a question. If you notice in the Gospel of Luke, constantly Jesus is being asked a question, and he always diverts it because he has his own agenda. He has something very important to say. And so instead, complicating the question and confounding the questioner who implied that he or she was among those being saved, Jesus curtly responded, "Strive to enter through the narrow gate." He is the narrow gate. His teaching, his example. Now, led by the Spirit, Edith Stein entered through the narrow gate in 1933, joining the Descalzos Carmelites, 1933. You know, we can't put ourselves into the faith mindset of that time. It was a very strange mindset in many ways, very narrow, very deterministic. You did certain things, and inevitably certain things would follow. I was raised in that same spirit in the seminary. Would that it were so simple. Conversion doesn't come from the outside. Conversion comes from the inside. There was arduous physical work in that monastery to foster a spirit of docility, of obedience. There was silence, so difficult for a woman who was always engaged in dialogue, in the study of philosophy, trying to enter into the minds of one another as they came to understand more profoundly truth. The command to cease studying or writing under the obedience. "You will do this because we say so." That was the spirit of the day. And there was the virus of anti-Semitism that even penetrated the walls of that Carmelite convent. In 1933, a persecution called Kristallnacht took place in Germany. Jewish shopkeepers were arrested, some put to death, stores were looted, synagogues burned, and the whole world was shocked. Edith, now known as Sister Therese Benedicta of the Cross, was moved to Holland to protect her. War broke out, and Holland, among all the other nations, was overwhelmed by this grief. Sister Therese Benedicta of the Cross could have escaped to Israel or Switzerland, but she chose to stay as a disciple of Jesus and a daughter of her people. In 1942, with hundreds of other convert Jews, she was sent to Auschwitz, and in August was put to death. Enter through the narrow gate. So did Sister Teresa Benedicta of the Cross. And in 1998, Pope John Paul II named her a saint of the Catholic Church. Enter through the narrow gate. So Jesus to you and to me. We don't have to leave who we are and what we do. The woman in the kitchen or office, or the man walking at top speed or Bluetooth computer can be and should be as holy as the nun in the convent, the priest in the monastery, or the rectory. Choosing to follow Jesus in his way, led by the Spirit, allowing his teaching and his example to lead us from violence and greed, from egoism and lust, from the spirit of the day that does not respect people, to lead us from vengeance to a spirit of mercy. Trusting beyond any proof that all we are and all that we do has meaning before God. What a beautiful teaching Christ gives to us. That no matter where we are, no matter what we do, it all has meaning before God. And then to be part of this reign of God that reaches out and invites other people to follow where we have led. Enter through the narrow gate. The Lord beckons each of us. Endure your trials and rejoice in life. And the ordinary is the place of the holy. So do we follow the way of Jesus, the way of Dr. Edith Stein.